I still don't think that that can inflame on what is right and what is wrong. And I've been incredibly blessed to even have a chance to be a head coach, particularly at a place like this. I'm not deserving of having an opportunity to talk to you on national radio. That's not how I grew up. That's not what it was about. But how I was raised and how I did grow up is right is right and wrong is wrong. And no amount of money or no amount of a position or of a title should change what's right and what's wrong. Our kids are great kids. They made a mistake. It was not something that warranted multi-game or a multi-game suspension. They understood. They were disappointed. But, you know, we don't really talk about the time of the year. We won five in a row. Or West Virginia has got a lot of state. We don't talk about those things. And we don't talk about those things if everybody's playing. We don't talk about those things if we have two guys hurt, zero guys hurt. If the team room broken, there's the consequence. Let's move on. And so we moved on since then. We actually moved on before the game ever started, even though from a publicity standpoint, it was just beginning. And then, of course, I had like a clown at the end of the game. So that just further strengthens everybody's grip on it. But I thought it was the right thing to do. Kids understood. And we'll continue, hopefully, to progress on the same plane that we've been on.
24-5, they're 13-3. You know, found a buzz, I say to you, well, why don't you lean on your captain or your captains for support? But you don't have captains. How come? Lay it out philosophically.
No, I don't. Yeah, it is a philosophical thing. It may be immature on my part. Maybe as I grow as a coach, I would have a different thought process on it. Every kid is important. Every kid has the same value to our program. Every kid has different skill sets. Some are more talented than others in certain ways. Some are more talented as teammates. Some are more talented as shooters. But I think I'm doing a disservice to a freshman to say, hey, you know what's going on. So pay attention to this guy. We should all pay attention to one another. And I think that was my disappointment in acting the way that I did after the game. I wouldn't want our kids to do that. So why do I feel like this? Because I'm the head coach that I can do that. I can't do that. And so I have never anointed anybody as captain. I think you got to have both feet in every single day, whether you're a manager, you're an administrative assistant, whether you're a freshman, whether you're an all-conference player, because that's the only way that you can work to give yourself a chance to play after spring break. And from a competitive standpoint, that's what all of this is. You know, you're not playing to get in the tournament. You're playing to win the tournament. And so I just don't feel like saying this guy is my captain or these guys are my captain. I don't think I'm going to put other guys ahead of kids that are not captains in the same manner that just because I'm the head coach, I shouldn't treat or talk to my assistants any different. I think everybody has an important, critical role. Responsibility, and you want to create ownership from top to bottom and bottom to top in your organization, and that's just what I believe. And again, that may be an immature response, but that's what I believe. And so far, I think we've had average success. Hopefully, we'll continue to be better.
It's working now. 316 last year, top 10 right now. Last thought, Buzz. The first hour, we spent a lot of time talking about the All-Star game yesterday. Dwayne Wade with that hard foul on Kobe Bryant. I think most people know that he played his college ball at Marquette, led the team to the Final Four in 2003. Does he stay connected to the program? Does he ever reach out to you?
He's the absolute best. He has been the absolute best. And, you know, I didn't see the foul, so I can't speak to that. Our team was at my house, and they were watching the game in another room, and I was talking to the coaches. But Dwayne has been phenomenal in regards to building a relationship with me and being willing to do that. Coach Green recruited Dwayne. Coach Green coached Dwayne. I've never tried to take credit or coach in any other way other than that's all Coach Green and his staff that was here. But Dwayne really cares about Marquette. He's on campus. I would say probably the run was about 3 times a year. I was able to work with Shannon at camp this summer. I was beginning to be around him for 72 consecutive hours. It was healthy for our relationship. I probably talked to him once a month, whether that be over the phone or through text. But he's been great. Scholarship program through the Boys and Girls Club of America that he funnels through Marquette. So there's, I think this year, Jim, there's five kids that joined through his foundation of paying for them to have a full scholarship to Marquette. Kids that are first-time college kids within their family. And so his heart here is much deeper than just being a great basketball player. And so I'm a huge Dwayne Wade fan.
Hey, Buzz, from my side, I understand that you've got a job, you've got a challenge. You know, but I listen to you, and you say things like, you know, I'm really not worthy of this, I didn't aspire to this, this is there in my plan. I believe that. I think you're sincere. I think you're genuine when you say that. The fact of the matter is, you are working your plan, and it's working, and you're getting more and more attention. You know, have you got bright lights, big city in the back of your mind?
I don't know. You know, I think sometimes I come across as just an all-shucks kind of guy, and in a lot of ways, I'm probably a little smarter than I act. It's not an act. It's just who I am. Regardless of our success, I want to make sure that I'm humble and how I handle it. I think that's an appropriate example for our kids. I think society grows so instant gratification and Twitter this, Facebook this, and you just get so blown out of proportion so quickly. We've been blessed. This is way more than I dreamed of. I'm living the dream. And in the midst of the dream, I want to make sure that I absorb all the lessons that I need to absorb, not just as a coach, way more important as a husband and as a father and just as a man. I'm more competitive than I have, and I think sometimes that comes across here in the game. Sometimes that comes across in the wrong way, like at the end of West Virginia. But I'm just humble and thankful. But that doesn't mean that I'm not taking a step back. I like to compete, but I want to compete the right way. And how this all plays out, I don't know, but it sure is a lot of fun to be a part of it. And I think the other piece that I always say to you, because I appreciate how you asked the question, there is a deep-seated fear in me, and that fear is unknown. And so along the path of success, I never want to think that I deserve it, and I never want to get caught up in this is the way it's supposed to be. Because I think part of the reason of the rhythm or a byproduct of our success is how we go about it on a day-to-day basis and being accountable for our work on a day-to-day basis. And there is a deep-seated fear that if you don't work today, you don't get to eat tomorrow. And so let's make sure we work today so we eat tomorrow. And there's some work to be done, then we'll just enjoy the meal a little bit longer. But we still got to get back to work. So I know that's simple in approach, but I think when you grow up in the country, you got to wake up when the sun comes up. A day's work is worth a day's pay.